Greetings everyone. I hope you are blessed under the love, under the peace, under the abundance life that God has given us. We are here again in your screen. We are Jesus to the world, God's love letter to the world. Today's episode, I just want to talk about a topic that has to do more with deliverance. And I just want to share the heart of God unto you. And I want us to have our reading in the book of Romans chapter 3. Right there we read verse 23. And I want us also to consider John chapter 8. Right there I want us to consider verse 34 and verse 36. And I want us to consider as well Ephesians chapter 4 verse 8. Quickly in my version, I know you can read it in your version, and we really, really appreciate that. I really, really appreciate that you move with us and you are blessed by God's heart to you from us, Jesus to the world, God's love letter to the world. In my version, it says, Romans chapter 3, verse 23, it says, for all men have sinned and has fallen short of the glory of God. It says, all men have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. All men have sinned. Mark the words, all men have sinned. And they have fallen short of the glory of God. What a tragedy. In John chapter 8, verse 3, verse 33, 34 rather, it says, Jesus answered, very lie, I say unto you, whoever committeth sin is a servant to sin. What a tragedy. Truly, truly, Jesus says, I tell you, whoever commits sin is a slave. He is a slave to sin. What a tragedy. I'm reading this, I'm thinking, may I be a slave to sin? May you be a slave to sin? It says, whoever commits sin is a slave to sin. In other words, there is no happy sin. And by all means, if we can consider everything, we realize that when you are in sin, it's only a temporary play. Deep down, we know we are not happy in sin. Deep down, we know there is no fulfillment to the life of a man. In sin, there's no fulfillment in sin. We know a man who is in sin is a man that lacks the peace of God, is a man that lacks the inner joy. It may give you temporary happiness, but you know you keep going for more because you think it will fill the space in your heart for the presence of God. But we know it will not fill the space in your heart for the presence of God. So the Bible says, I tell you very lie, truly, truly, I tell you, whoever commits sin is a slave to sin. And verse 36 right there, it says, if the Son, I love this. These are positive news, ladies and gentlemen. These are positive news. When we say we are God's love letter to you, this is the letter. The Bible says, if the Son therefore shall make you free, you are free indeed. If the Son shall make you free, you are free indeed. And in the book of Ephesians chapter 4, verse 8, it says, wherefore he saith, when he ascended on high, he led captivity captive, and he gave gifts unto men. Daddy, we thank you for the reading of your word. And we know that your word comes because you love us. You chasten those you love. Thank you so much, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living. I want to speak briefly on the topic that has to do with the deliverance, ladies and gentlemen, brethren. The Bible says this, we know, the Bible says all men have sinned. The Bible says Tom has sinned. The Bible says Michael has sinned. The Bible says my mother has sinned. And they have fallen short of the glory of God. And the Bible says by them sinning and falling short of the glory of God, they were partaking in the tragedy that makes them slaves to sin. But I love the good news. It looks, when you listen to this news that we've sinned and we've fallen short of the glory of God, that we are slaves to sin, that we don't control ourselves, because a slave doesn't control himself. The slave doesn't control himself. When we hear them, we are shocked, you know. When we hear them, we are troubled, you know. When we hear them, we don't find hope in them. But these are the good news. This is the gospel of Jesus Christ. The gospel of Jesus Christ says, if the Son of God sets you free, my sister, my brother, you are free indeed. And this is what I want to talk about. In the book of Ephesians chapter 4, verse 8, the Bible says, when he ascended on high. And I love this particular passage of scripture, because most of the times when we talk about Ephesians chapter 4, we are addressing the gifts of the Holy Spirit. But I want to tell you that truly God has released gifts. God has released grace unto men. But it is impossible to enjoy the grace of God. It is impossible to enjoy the gifts of God unless you find mercy for deliverance. That's why the Bible says, before the Bible says he gave gifts unto men, the Bible begins by saying, when he ascended on high, he led captivity captive. I want you to mark that, because it's very important. The Bible says he led captivity captive and he gave gifts unto men. And I don't want to talk about gifts today, because these are the good news. Oh, we received grace. We received many other gifts as the church, as the body of Christ, as individuals, as members of the body of Christ, as sons and daughters of the kingdom, as God's creator. The Bible says he created us in his own image and likeness, and we received a lot of gifts. But I want to talk about this. I say, even though God has released gifts for you, even though God has released grace for you, in the absence of mercy, unless mercy qualifies you, let me put it like this, it is mercy that will qualify you to enjoy grace. It is deliverance that will qualify you to enjoy the gifts of God. The Bible says when he ascended on high, and I love this passage of scripture, the Bible says when he ascended on high, he led captivity captive. What is captivity? Let us explain it put in an example to explain it. The Bible, you would realize that in the journey of Israel, when they sinned, God gave them up. God left the children of Israel to be taken to captive by the Babylonians. And there in captivity, they became slaves in captivity. There in captivity, they became workers. They became people who are forced against their will to serve people they don't want to serve. And slave in our time, we can liken it to a prison. So the Bible says when Jesus ascended on high, he led prison into prison. Oh, what a good news. So the prison, let me put it like this. If we were to put it in our modern understanding, we were supposed to say when Jesus ascended on high, he arrested prison. He took prison to prison. So when the devil wants to punish you, the weapon of the devil is to keep you in captivity to sin, is to keep you in the prison of sin. But the Bible says when Jesus ascended on high, he dealt with that prison of sin. He took the prison of sin and he arrested it and he put it in a prison. So good news, these are the good news. A prison is arrested. The good news is prison no longer has power over you. The prison of sin, the prison of generational curses, the prison of wickedness no longer has power over you. The prison of addictions no longer has power over you. And whenever the devil wants to tell you that you cannot serve God because, you see, you are addicted to pornography, and if people know you don't deserve to serve God, just look at him, you say, sir, devil, you don't know. Your prison is arrested. The Bible says when Jesus ascended on high, he led captivity into captive. He took the prison and he put it in prison. So prison is not free anymore. Prison is not free to suppress you anymore. Prison is arrested by Jesus. Sin is arrested by Jesus. And I want to encourage you that you take a conscious decision today to say, Jesus has won, and I want to partake into the victory of the cross. I want to partake into the deliverance that Jesus has achieved in the cross. I want to partake. I'm saying, how can I be in prison when Jesus had power to arrest prison? Because the Bible says captivity, when he ascended on high, he led captivity captive. So captivity itself, it's not free. Captivity is captive. So this is a chance to escape captivity, because captivity is powerless. I love this. Somebody, if you were here with me, I want you to say captivity is captive. I want you to say the power of my addiction is held captive by Jesus Christ. I want you to say the power of my addiction has been arrested by the power of Jesus, by the blood of Jesus, by the cross of Jesus, by the sacrifice, the power of your addiction, the power of the sin that has been easily entangling unto you, the power that power has been arrested. And I want you to, with your head held high, I want you to say, I am not a sinner anymore. I want you to say, I cannot be defeated in sin anymore. I want you to say, I will live life and life in abundance according to the will of God, because God has defeated captivity. Somebody, I just want to tell you this. When Jesus Christ ascended on high, before he gave gifts unto men, he began by dealing with the prison of the devil. He began by arresting the prison of the devil, so that the devil is no longer in charge of his own prison, because his own prison has been arrested by the power of Jesus. And after he arrested the prison itself, after he arrested captivity itself, and he led it into captivity, the Bible says he gave gifts unto men. Lord Jesus, we can enjoy gifts today, because we know that when the devil comes and say you cannot enjoy the gift of God, you don't deserve to enjoy the grace of God, you yourself, you don't deserve to enjoy the gifts of God, we look into him, we say, devil, you are proposing captivity into me, you are proposing prison into me, but alas on you, because you don't even have the keys of that prison you are trying to arrest me. Because the Bible says when Jesus ascended on high, he left captivity into captivity. And the Bible says he took the keys of the kingdom. He took the keys. The devil does not have keys anymore. The devil is in prison. And I want to encourage you, ladies and gentlemen, that something about life, and most importantly about life, is that the devil claims to have power, he does not have. I don't know the circumstance you find yourself and you are blaming the devil for it, and perhaps he really contributed a lot to your calamities. But I want to tell you that the devil claims to have power, he does not have. The power of the devil is in ignorance. The power of the devil is in you not knowing your rights. The power of the devil is you not knowing what Jesus did for you. But today I just want to enlighten you wherever you are. I want you to be blessed by this message and really be enlightened and know that the devil does not have power over you. That sin does not have power over you. That addictions don't have power. Curses don't have power over you. Most importantly, because when Jesus ascended on high, he led captivity captive, and he gave gifts unto men. The Bible says, he who is set free by the Son is free indeed. Wherever you are, I want you to say, I am set free by the Son, and I am free indeed. Wherever you are, I want you to say, the prison of the devil is arrested. Oh, alas, devil, you don't have keys to your own prison anymore. How can you arrest me? Oh, Lord Jesus. So I want you, wherever you are, I want you to take a conscious decision, because something, the Bible says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should be saved, and whoever does not believe in him is condemned already, because he has not believed in the only begotten of God. So I want you to take a conscious decision and say, today I just want to join. Today I want to subject my life under the leadership, under the lordship of Jesus Christ. Most importantly, I want to escape every manner of captivity. I want to escape every manner of the calamities of the dark world. I want to escape everything that may be following, that may be pursuing me, that may be really attempting to put me in captivity. I want to escape addictions. I want to escape this. I just want to really subject myself under the life who is really Jesus Christ. I just want to tell you that Jesus has done it for you. I want you to believe in Jesus. I want you to live the life full of deliverance, the life full of peace and joy that Jesus gives you. The Bible says he led captivity captive. Tell me, brother, tell me, sister, why are you still suffering? Why are you still blaming the witches? Why are you still blaming the devil when the devil does not even have keys for his own prison? Jesus took it. Jesus arrested the devil's prison. The only thing you need to do now is to raise your hands and say, Jesus, I accept you as my leader. Because I know that if Jesus, you are the leader of my life, there's no way I can be in captivity when you, Jesus, your own self, you arrested prison. Oh, what good news. Oh, what good news. I want you to tell your friends. I want you to tell your family. I want you to write this down. These are the good news. Prison has been arrested. These are the good news. But wherever you are, I want you to receive this good news. I want you to subject your life into the victory of the cross. I just want you to agree. The Bible says, can the two walk together unless they agree? Jesus has begun it by defeating the devil. Do you agree with him when he invites you to partake in the victory of his own cross? If you agree with Jesus, I want you to raise your hands. And I want you to follow me in this prayer. And I want to tell you, when you follow me in this prayer, your life will never be the same again. You will see the chains being broken. The Bible says, and the yoke will be destroyed because of an anointing. And I know that often we preach the scripture, we say the yoke will be broken because of anointing, in reference that when we receive anointing for ministry, it will break yokes. That is true. But primarily the Bible says how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power, and he went about doing good and healing all those that were oppressed. So I want to tell you that primarily how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth. It is that anointing that God has put in Jesus of Nazareth that when you receive him, yokes will be broken. Yokes will be broken from your neck, and you will receive and you will enjoy the true liberty of the sons of God, the true freedom of the sons of God. I want you to raise your hands. As you raise your hands, I want you to follow me in this prayer. Say, Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ, I receive you as the Lord and the Savior for my life. From today, you are my Lord. From today, I am born again. From today, the devil no longer has power over me. I denounce every covenant that I made consciously or that was made for me.